If you look at the range of live oak in the southeast, there's kind of a big chunk in East Texas, but most of the rest of the range hugs the coast. And so they're really a distinctive characteristic tree of this region.
Live oaks are forest trees, but they can thrive in cities. Today, we look at live oaks in Tallahassee's urban forest.
Behind me is the brick St. James CME Church, predominantly African-American congregation dating all the way back to 1822. This is one of the rare cases in downtown where you get to see a big live oak tree in association with the building that it was originally associated with. So often downtown on Bruneau and Duval, there's big trees along the street, but those were for houses that are no longer there. Now this tree was exceedingly lucky. Live oaks like to do this occasionally. They like to throw out their limb and kind of rest it on the ground and say, oh, thank you.
Another thing I'll point out is when these limbs come down and touch the ground like these are doing over here, leave them alone because they are also taking weight off of the main mass of the tree.
The lichgate oak is a good example of how big a live oak can get when it's given space. And this is much more space than oaks get in the wild.
Right now, we're entering into a longleaf pine forest. So this is an area that gets regular burning. And you can see out here, you've got hardwoods coming up like some oaks and stuff, but they're all pretty small because the fire knocks them back. And then you've got these longleaf pine with this brown cover. We're going to go walk in a little bit further. We're going to see something different. And we're going to talk about that. Now we're getting to an area where we don't get much fire. So now we're at the edge of a pond. Fire rarely gets down here because it's just too damp. And then you get this natural live oak forest. If you look around the whole pond, you can see a lot of the hardwoods, not all of them, but most of them are live oaks.
In a wooded area, they're not gonna take this open grown form, so they're gonna be a little bit more slender.
You also notice in the woods when they grow pretty straight up.
Yep.
When you open it up in a pasture,
yeah,
then's when they begin to spread.
Yep.
And that's what impresses people when they can see that mass.
It's nice and cool under here. That's part of why these trees are thriving right next to a fire-dependent ecosystem.
Feel the temperature cooling down, and that's what happens to the fire too. So as you get closer, the fire behavior starts to slow down a little bit.
The same effect makes it a useful urban tree.
The major benefit of the live oak is the size of the canopy. So it provides an immense amount of shade, and of course that's very important to have near pavement, over sidewalks, to reduce that urban heat island.
I'm just going to come back to Occam's razor. You know, the simplest answer is the easiest answer. People like the big trees because it is hot here. And we see these big trees as forming big pools of cool shade. And we see birds playing in them, and we see squirrels running up and down them, and we see Spanish moss hanging in the oh-so-perfectly artistic Southern Gothic sort of way. It's a natural affinity.
A single live oak is an ecosystem supporting numerous plant and animal species.
Probably well over 1,000 when you count plants, animals, insect larvae, all those types of things. Everybody knows about Spanish moss. That's an air plant, a bromeliad type plant that gets its nutrients from the air. So it's not actually sinking roots into the tree and stealing nutrients or anything. Same with something called resurrection fern, which people see on the top branches of live oaks quite frequently. They'll turn brown in the winter and then green again in the spring. And they're just kind of living on the bark, so it's a symbiotic, friendly relationship.
The lichen, the algae, produces food from photosynthesis, and the fungus kind of helps it live better and collect nutrients better.
They also host 500 plus species of insect larvae, caterpillars, which are super valuable for our songbirds that eat insects exclusively, in addition to being close to those animals themselves. There's lots of different species of galls that affect oak trees. Typically an insect will lay an egg on the oak twig, and it kind of grows wood around it. That's the tree's way of sealing off issues that it identifies as problems. That little bug will mature inside the gall and eventually come out. Usually no harm, no foul.
A recent survey of Tallahassee's urban forest determined that live oaks are our fourth most numerous tree, making up 7% of the city's canopy.
So out of those top five, the live oak is really the only high-value, long-lived urban tree species that we have.
First off, don't just plant one kind of tree. You set yourself up for disasters. But I do think that live oaks are native. They've got really distinct character. Mm-hmm. They really, really help this community identify with it. Just, you know, if it's 7% of the canopy, as you were saying, Mindy had come up with, that's great. You know, 10% is probably okay. I wouldn't do 50.
A diverse urban canopy encourages a diversity of wildlife within our city limits. Live oaks are an iconic component of the Tallahassee ecosystem. For WFSU, I'm Rob Diaz de Villegas.